so to travel, to Julia Low Bue-Said, who's CEO at Advantage Travel Partnerships. That's the country's largest independent travel agent and travel management. Any facts and figures exactly with the impact that it has been so far? And of course, you and your colleagues have missed out. Good morning.
Good morning. Yes. Hello, Nick. Well, yes, we have absolutely missed out and absolutely, you know, waking up again this morning in disbelief that a sector that has suffered 20 months of consistent restrictions. Let's not forget, our members have never traded without any restrictions. Find themselves at the bottom of, not even at the bottom of the pit. They're completely not in the pit whatsoever. Completely ignored. And to give you an extent of the devastation that's been caused, Nick. So our sector, our membership has been trading at around 80% down since March 2020.
Right.
You are talking about a million jobs here. You know, pre-COVID times contribution to GDP was around 70 billion. I was listening to some of the numbers before, weddings, gyms, everything else. I mean, the travel industry is 7-8 times that. And to not even get a look in, to not even get in within scope of what's been announced is absolutely appalling. I'd love to ask Rishi Sunak why he has not met with the travel industry and why he sees the travel industry as a sector that can just be left at the bottom of the barrel is beyond my comprehension. But I would like to ask him, and I've just asked him that. So it's a really devastating time. And
what the government would say, the government would say that there are still measures that are offering relief until March of next year. SSP, statutory sick pay, is available. That should help some of the staffing, is what you might hear, Julie. How would you react to that?
Well, it does not even scratch the surface at all, Nick. When you're a sector that relies on international travel, I was thinking from your previous experts that were on the calls before, if you consider the impact cancellations for restaurants. So, you know, people are a bit worried and concerned about going into restaurants because of government messaging and narrative. Imagine what that does if you're thinking about booking a travel trip, a holiday, a business meeting. Imagine what that does. And that's what our sector is affected with. The confidence has hit rock bottom.
I look forward to speaking in the new year, because thank you for all the help you've given me through this year, for some positive news, because it's such a vital industry that you represent. Not just because of the staff involved, which is big enough, but also the fact that in human life you like to have things to look forward to. And I appreciate some of you think travelling is almost the work of the devil at the moment, but for many people, the ability to go and see loved ones, to show off new babies, to put your arms around someone because, you know, you lost your grandma and you hug your granddad or whatever, it's a vital human requirement. Plus the fact just to have a break. And just to get away with your husbands, your wives, your lovers and your children and just sit in the sun or sit in the snow, it doesn't matter. It's so crucial just to the human psyche. Julia Low Bue-Said, let's hope we have happier conversations in the new year. Your CEO at Advantage Travel Partnership.